Hello everyone and welcome to YouTube channel of Arihant Academy. This is Divesh Arora here representing Mathematics Department from ICSE section. I'm specifying ICSE section because a good crowd is giving this CET exam. In short, if anyone wants to drift to Maharashtra board, he or she has to give CET exam. So there is a bit of chaos and confusion amongst the students whether ICSE kids would be able to give this exam or not. Yes, we are facing these problems and hence I am sharing this with you all. There is nothing to worry, dear students. Entire syllabus of ICSE that you all have been going through since standard 8th and 9th, and definitely whatever you all have learned in 10th as well, is going to be covered in CET. In short, CET of Maharashtra. In short, it would be a very smooth go for you all. You all have to just get well versed with the pattern and the topics that they have. Everything is in sync, don't worry. The only thing is that you are entering into a different house called as SSC, and hence thoda sa aap logo ko dar lag raha hai, and it will be vanished. Don't worry, let's take a deep dive into the two topics that I have been assigned. Jo do topic hume saath mein karne hai, one is linear equation in two variables and second is arithmetic progression. Before we move ahead, dear students, let me clear your mindset. This is an MCQ based exam. So your working and everything has to be in rough. Your lengthy process of calculation does not matter. You just have to click on the correct answer. So just keep your basics and concepts strong. Rest everything will fall at its place. Fine. So let's move ahead. As you all can see, linear equation in two variables. The word linear, dear students, is an adjective form of the word line. Equation, simple, it has to have an equal to ka symbol within it. And two variables, x and y. So as you all can see, ax plus by, as you all can see here, ax plus by equals to 0. In this, the two variables being x and y, okay, and a, b and c, these are the coefficients, and last c is the constant. A and b are the coefficients and c is the constant. And the second pointer, which is here, highest index of the variable is 1. X and y dono ka highest power should be 1. So this is a perfect example that you all can see here. 2x plus 3y plus 5 equals to 0. As the required conditions are satisfied here or not, let us cross check. Here the role of A is played by 2, role of B is played by 3, and role of C is played by 5, and each variable, that is x and y, have the highest power 1. You also have quadratic equation. Quadratic equation mein you have the highest power as 2. So here we are supposed to, this is the general format of linear equation. Why I'm discussing this in detail, students, is for a simple fact. You come across a question wherein you need to identify whether the given question is a linear equation in two variables or not. Okay, let's have a look at it. Identify the linear equation in two variables from the following. Let us go back and recall the basics that we had seen. As you all can see here, the first one, root 3x plus root 5y equals to 10, is a variable over here satisfying, is a variable x and y satisfying the criteria of having the highest index 1? The answer is yes. The role of A, the place of A is taken by root 3, the place of B is taken by root 5, and C ka value is 10. So yes, I have collected my answer as A. I keep this in my mind. That means most probably this has to be the answer. However, when I go to my option B here, as we had seen the condition, B should not be equal to 0. But here if you can see, B is equal to 0. So this is not satisfying the criteria. So in my mind, I have made up that this is not the answer. Again, when I consider this X and Y over here, actually speaking, when I drag this up, I make this as 4x raised to minus 1. As per law of indices, when this x moves up its variable, its power will be minus 1. So hence this is also not your answer. Again, when you have a look at option D mein highest power of the variable x is 2. Hence this also gets cancelled. So for taxi, you can go and click on the answer A. A is your answer for the first one. MCQ based exam hai. You have to be very clear with what is the correct answer. There are few questions which seem to be difficult, but then they are very simple. Just click and move to the next. Now just have a look here at this particular question, linear equation in two variables. Now there are certain questions which are a bit tricky and very simple to solve. Now when I'm saying about this particular equation, 15x plus 12y equals to 9 and 12x plus 15y equals to 6, and you need to find out the value of x minus y over here. Now see, there are various ways to solve this sums. When I consider this as 15x plus 12y equals to 9, I tag this as my equation 1, and I go to second one, 12x plus 15y equals to 6. I know y'all have gone through the various methods. Case mein hum log add, subtract, add method follow karte hain. But then, dear students, this is MCQ based exams, as I have been saying. Itna time dalna nahi hai. Your smarter tricks of calculating the sum matters a lot here. Now the point that I am trying to highlight here is x minus y ka answer humko chahiye. So subtraction of the equation should come into the picture with y ka coefficient having a negative sign. Let's see here. If I write subtracting equation 2 from 1, simple. If I put up subtracting equation 2 from 1, what do we get? We need to change the sign over here. Okay, so this gives you 3x and this gives you minus 3y, which is equals to, again the sign this changes here, which is equals to 3. So directly you will get the value of x minus 3 when you write a note or you take 3 common over here. So you will get x minus y ka answer equals to 1 directly. So your answer is A. Am I clear, dear students? Or is the other way around? Suppose, let us consider if they are giving you to find out x plus y. Then I suppose it should be very clear in your mind. See, you have to explore what all options can come. Now, if you want to find out x plus y, so how do you play with these two equations? Is you need to add instead of subtracting, you need to add. So while adding, it will give you 27x plus 27y equals to some answer. And then you divide it by, you take the answer 27 common and you divide it by 27 and you get the further answer. Fine. So these are few tricks that you should understand. Or else the other way around, if you drag it to the lengthier process of adding the equation, then subtracting the equation, then again adding, the way you'll have learned the process and the method to solve this entire equation, it would go too lengthy. So the marks allocated for your one question is 1, and the time limit is also accordingly given. So you have to be smarter in terms of your calculation, dear students. This is the point that I'm trying to explain. We move to the next part. Linear equation in two variables, how do you represent it on a graph? Graph of any linear equation is always a straight line. The very first point when I started the topic, I had said linear means in a line. Aap kisi bhi graph ko, you consider any graph, any linear equation in two variables and you put it on a graph, it will be a straight line. This is what the first point indicates. Equation of x-axis, I'll just put up a coordinate system in rough. Okay, if I put up a coordinate system over here, this is my x-axis, this is my y-axis, and if I consider equation of x-axis, where does x-axis cut y-axis? At origin. And hence, equation of your x-axis is y equals to 0, and vice versa, equation of y-axis is x equals to 0. Don't get confused with this. The coordinate of point of intersection of x-axis and y-axis, as you all can see, is origin. My dear students, the next point coming up is very important. Students get confused. What is this abscissa? Abscissa is nothing but your x-coordinate. Abscissa, as I said, is nothing but your x coordinate. abscissa is x coordinate. Okay, and ordinate, when we say ordinate, is nothing but your y coordinate. Okay, so you have to be well versed with these terminologies, because there are certain questions which are asked in such a way and you're not aware of the terminology, so you lose your one mark in this MCQ based exam. Fine, so we are clear with the basics of this. Let's see the sums or the MCQs that are based on this particular type of topic. To draw the graph of equation 2x minus 6y equals to 3, if y is equals to 0, then x is equals to question mark. I suppose this sounds very simple. You just need to put up 2x minus 6y is equals to 3 and substitute y is equals to 0. So when you substitute, I'm not putting up all the steps here, my dear students. So when you substitute y is equals to 0, what are you left out with? 6 into 0 over here is 3. This gives you 0. So 2x is equals to 3. Your x ka value is 3 upon 2. You got the answer. Tick on A and let's move to the next one. I suppose it was very simple. These type of questions would be asked. Don't worry. Out of the blues, kuch bhi nahi aayega syllabus mein. Exam would be a very smooth go for you all. Let's go to the next question. The point of intersection of lines represented by 2x plus 3y equals to 12 and y-axis is. Now here you need to apply a bit of brains. Jahan pe any point, any line, in fact, if I consider a line over here, this is my coordinate system. If I consider a line which intersects my y-axis at a particular point, uska x-coordinate you can take as 0. So what are you doing over here is, you are substituting x equals to 0 in this particular equation. So when you substitute x is equals to 0, what is it that you get? 2 into 0 plus 3y. Mind you, the way you will be using your rough note, same way I'm using this notepad as a rough note, and this is how you're supposed to get the answers very quickly, dear students. So 2 into 0 plus 3y equals to 12. So 3y is equals to 12. So y is equals to 4. When you get y is equals to 4, and already you had defined x as 0, so 0 comma 4 should be your answer. Am I clear with this, students? Fine. Let's move to the next one here. Now, the points to remember with respect to the consistency of line. When you have two equations given as a1x plus b1y equals to c1 and second one is a2x plus b2y equals to c2. If this is the condition, a1 upon a2 does not match with b1 upon b2, then the two lines, the two graphs will have unique solution. Unique solution means they will intersect each other at a defined point. And graphically, they will intersect each other. Kuch to is tarike se dikhega aapko. This is your graph, x-axis and y-axis. Two lines intersecting would be of this form. It will have a defined point. It will have these two lines which we are considering, having a1 upon a2 as not equal to b1 upon b2, these two lines will have a unique, a clear-cut solution, and the lines would be kaisa lines? The lines would be intersecting lines graphically. This is first condition of consistency of the line. The second condition we go to, if your a1 upon a2 is equal to b1 upon b2 but not equal to c1 upon c2, before students going to this, they just have a look at this particular one, the third one, and they conclude the lines are coinciding lines or infinitely many solutions. So no, you have to check all three. If a1 upon a2 is equal to b1 upon b2, which is not equal to c1 upon c2, then there are two things that the questions can be based on. Number one, how are the lines? So the lines are parallel over here. And algebraically, what is their solution? Such graphs have no solution. Isko agar hum log present karenge graph pe, let us have a look here. It would be somewhat this way. If I consider a line like this, another line which goes would be this way. Now, there is no question that these two lines would intersect, because they are dashed to each other. They are पैरेलल टू इच अदर. अगर पैरेलल लाइंस होगा तो इंटरसेक्शन पॉइंट आएगा ही नहीं, बिकॉज दैट्स अ डेफिनेशन ऑफ पैरेलल लाइंस, दे डू नॉट इंटरसेक्ट. सो यूनिक सॉल्यूशन तो बहुत दूर, सच काइंड ऑफ लाइंस विल हैव नो सॉल्यूशंस. वेल, when we consider this kind of situation, when a1 upon a2 is equal to b1 upon b2, which is equal to c1 upon c2, infinitely many solutions. Now this is a process jo aapko sochna hai pehle ki aisa type of graph kaisa aayega. I'll represent this as well. Let me consider a graphical solution in rough and I draw a line. Okay, I consider a line. The second line which we are talking would be coinciding on this line, would be overlapping on this line, मतलब वो लाइन भी इसी लाइन के ऊपर आएगा, उसके कोऑर्डिनेट्स भी इसके साथ उसके ऊपर ही रहेंगे. सो सच टाइप ऑफ लाइन्स आर कॉल्ड एज कोइंसाइडिंग लाइन्स. सो वॉट वी डू हियर इज वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड, आई जस्ट पुट अप द थ्री कंडीशंस. टू आर ऑलरेडी सीन हियर, द टू कंडीशंस. लेट मी गो बैक टू द फर्स्ट वन. The first condition that we were talking is here, when a1 upon a2 is not equal to b1 upon b2, it's very simple. Kaisa type of a solution? It is a unique solution and lines, intersecting lines. Fine. Now let's move ahead to the second and third condition once again. a1 upon a2 is equal to b1 upon b2 but not equal to c1 upon c2. Such type of graphs will have no solution and these lines are parallel lines. And lastly, when all three ratios are equal, a1 upon a2 is equal to b1 upon b2 which is equal to c1 upon c2, such graphs have infinitely many solutions and the graphs coincide on each other. Ek ke upar ek wahi line overlap hoga. Let's take a quick look on the sums based on this. The simultaneous equation 3x plus 5y equals to 16 and 4x minus y equals to 6 have dash. Simple. Already the format is very much defined. Aapko MCQ basis pe sum ko solve karna hai. So you work out your a1 upon a2 which is 3 upon 4. This is your first one. Second one, when you go, it gives you 5 upon minus 1. The third one that you look as 16 upon 6. Basically, here itself, the solution is clear in my mind. It is unique solution. So why should I peep and go ahead? Correct? When a1 upon a2, let us recall, is not equal to b1 upon b2, we have unique solution. So this is how quickly you need to wrap up a sum and move ahead. Let's take a look at the next sum. Well, another section. The first part that we had seen in the topic was solving of simultaneous equation. The second part we saw the graphical representation and the third is determinant. Now, Cramer's rule jisko hum kehte hain, Cramer's rule se bhi aap simultaneous equation solve kar sakte hain. These are certain rules, these are certain basic format. a1x plus b1y equals to c1 and a2x plus b2y equals to c2. I need not go into the explanation part. This is a basic formula for determinant wherein everyone is comfortable. It's cross multiplication ad and then minus, the format says minus and b into c. Same way, all the determinants ka values are derived here. Okay, this is determinant, this is d of x, this is d of y, and if you want to find out your x ka value, your simultaneous equation is given by x comma y. So from here, if you want to work out x, the value of x is given by d of x upon d and value of y is given by d of y upon d. So this is how your Cramer's rule moves ahead. Let us take a look at the sums or the MCQs based on them. To solve x plus y equals to 3 and 3x minus 5 minus 2y equals minus 4 equals to 0, I'll have to modify my second equation over here. Now x plus y, which is equals to 3, and 3x minus 2y, I'll drag minus 4 on the other side, which gives me 4. I lock this into 1 and I lock this into 2, and we need to work out the value of determinant. Now let us go back to the previous slide. if you want to find out the value of D, only you need to involve A1, A2 and B1, B2. This is how columnar way may you have to understand the stuff. A1, A2 and B1, B2. Same way for D of X. When we are talking about D of X, you need not consider X ka variable as A2 and A1. If you observe D of X, isme A1 or A2 ko hi jagah nahi hai. So A1 or A2 ka column is occupied by the constant, that is C1 and C2, and this is B1 and B2. Well, we need not go in detail for understanding these formulas to that extent. This is a revision. All of you have gone through this. But still, ek bar hum kar rahe hain, isko revise, so ek bar nazar ghumate hain. Accordingly, when we go for D of Y, so D of Y mein, as I said, for D of X, X ke jagah pe constant aata hai, waise hi D of Y mein Y ke jagah pe, yani Y ke coefficient ke jagah pe, yani ke B1 aur B2 ke jagah pe, yahan pe, here you will get constant, and X ka coefficients, that is A1 and A2, remains as it is. So these are the basics that we need to understand, and based on which the sums would become very simple for us. Let's take a look here. The value of D is to be worked out. So when we talk about D here, D will be equal to, as we know, A1 ka place is taken by A1 ka coefficient. Don't get confused. It's nothing is there, means it's 1. And here A2 ka coefficient is 3. Same way, when I, here it should be B1 and B2. So B1 ka coefficient is 1 and B2 ka coefficient, dear students, is -2. Simple format of solving the equation is, you need to cross multiply them and then put the format ka negative sign. Nothing would go wrong. This is -2 into 1, which is -2. -3 into 1 is 3. Your answer has to be -5. Pehle mein khud tasalli le lunga. I'll satisfy myself by solving the sum, and then I'll hunt for the option. This looks more prominent. Still, I'll cross check. Ek mark ka sawal hai, whether it is right or wrong, I cross check. A1, A2, B1, B2, and then cross multiplying. Yes, now I'm confirmed, and hence I go to the next option. The value of M is to be found, wherein the determinant is -3, -5, M -4. The value of determinant is given as 18. Quickly, we'll not waste our time and we'll take the sum here. It goes -18, which will be equal to -3, -5, M and -4. I suppose it's very simple. What you need to do is cross multiply. -4 into -3 gives you 12. Format ka minus sign. And this gives you -5m. Finally, it is 12 plus 5m. The value left hand side was taken by minus of 18. You drag 12 over here, and what do you get, dear students, is minus 18 minus 12, which is equals to 5m. Minus 30 is equals to 5m. So your value for m is equals to -6. I worked out the value first and then I'll hunt for the option. Yes, this is the answer. And then second thing, that important thing that I'll do is I'll recheck. The value of the determinant given is 18. I have put up here, and this is the matrix that they have given. And then I cross multiply and cross check my answer. This gives me 12. I cross check my signs. I check the values, and then I'm confirmed with the answer and I go with the next thing. This was all, my dear students, with respect to first chapter, that is linear equation. Let's try to understand the second topic, that is arithmetic progression. I hope everyone was comfortable and it was a smooth go for you all, students. We'll go to the next topic, arithmetic progression now. Okay, let's go to the next topic, that is arithmetic progression. When we talk about the word progression, it means it's moving ahead. Sequence, as we say, there are many type of sequences. So far as subjective knowledge is concerned, arithmetic progression is one of them. Geometric progression is there. We have harmonic progression, but your syllabus is confined only to arithmetic progression. Before we move to any type of progression, we need to understand the meaning of the word sequence. As the definition states, a set of numbers arranged in a definite order. Now, when I am saying definite order, dear students, suppose if I am putting up a number, say 1, then 4. I have my mindset clear that for the numbers that I'm putting up here. Then I'll put up, say, 9. Then I suppose you are getting the next number in your mind. Yes, it has to be 16. Very nice. Then it has to be 25. Now what I have done? My mind was occupied with the squares of the natural numbers, beta. So square of 1 is 1. Square of 2 is 4. Square of 3 is 9. Square of 4 is 16. And square of 5 is 25. And hence, these numbers follow a definite order. As you can see, when I'm saying definite order, so these numbers which I'm putting up here are said to be in a sequence. This is one of the sequence. Okay. Yes. If I'm considering one more number, say one set of numbers, say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is one more sequence of natural number. Each number in the sequence is called as a term. This is 16 is basically the fourth term. So you can notify this as T of 4, fourth term. This 5 is a fifth term of the sequence. You can specify this as fifth term. We are just getting well versed with few of the terminologies over here, dear students. And when we take a deep dive into the set of formulas that we have here, the formulas will give you a good grip. I suppose everyone is clear as well with the formulas. Now, arithmetic progression means what? Now, before we go to the formulas, let's understand the meaning of the word arithmetic progression. As I had said, there are three types of progression, but your syllabus is confined to arithmetic progression. So, a set of numbers, a sequence which has a definite progression. Now, what do you mean by definite progression? Here, if you consider this set of numbers, which is given on the screen as 2, 4, 6, and 8, if you observe the difference between the consecutive terms, now when I'm saying the difference between the consecutive terms, always stick to your mind of preceding minus succeeding. Preceding minus succeeding. Preceding minus succeeding, and so on. So basically, this is your, when I'm putting up T1, this is my first term. This is my second term, this becomes my third term, and this becomes my fourth term. If I want to check whether a given sequence is an arithmetic progression or not, I will check T2 minus T1, which is 4 minus 2, which is 2. I'll also go for T3 minus T2. I said preceding minus succeeding. Aage wala number minus the behind number. So T3 minus T2 is 6 minus 4, which is again 2. If you see the difference between the two consecutive term is a constant, which is 2. Okay, this is called as a common difference. If you come across such type of sequences, you can also cross check with 8 minus 6, answer is 2. So if you come across such type of sequences which have differences in common, such sequences are said to be in AP. Yes, a very important point. The first term of your AP is denoted by A. It is also called as T1. So you should be very clear with these things, because MCQ based questions can be asked in anything, in any form. It can be in symbolic form also. They might ask you the answer. So you should be clear what the questions are about. Let's move ahead. Yes, the first formula that you should be very clear with is the nth term. Now when I'm talking about A, we are very clear. What do you mean by A, dear students? This is my first term. This is my first term. Now when I am talking about N, means I am talking about the term number. Term number. D is nothing but the common difference. D is nothing but the common difference. And T of N, this N is the same term number, but T of N is the value of nth term. Is the value of nth term. You should be very clear, your formula is made up of what? Number one, it is a value of the nth term. Number two, it is the first term. Number three, it is the number of terms. And number four, the common difference. So if you are very clear that the formula is composed of these four things, ye char mein se aapko log teen cheez denge. The three things would be given, or maybe it is in the hidden format, like, you know, they won't give you that the difference is given to you. They might not give the sequences in AP. You'll have to find out that sequences in AP with the common difference, and then you put up into the formula and get that expected answer. So in short, nothing would be fed directly in the question. It is you who are supposed to rack your brains and then have a knack of the formula and move ahead. We move to the next one. The sum based on AP, ninth term of AP is 0. Now mind you, you have to literally do a kind of postmortem to the given question. Now when they are saying if and then, if means what, my dear students? It is given to you. And then means they are asking something. I have tried to simplify the question very easy for you in a very simple way. If the ninth term of AP is 0, what can I do? If ninth term of AP is 0, means T of 9 I am working out, which is A plus 9 minus 1 into D. So T of 9, ninth term is 0. So ninth term ke badle mein I am putting up 0 over here, which is equals to A plus 8D. I lock this into my equation number 1. I have made some material ready to be used for the question that I am supposed to derive. They are asking us to find out the ratio. Now the word ratio means something upon something. So ratio of what? 29th term and 19th term. Now you should also be very smart. Suppose if they are asking you to find out the 9th term ka value, in terms of A and D, you have landed up to A plus 8D, dear students. Same way, if they are asking you to find out the 11th term, you should be smart enough to say the answer for this would be A plus 10D, because 10 minus 1 will give you, 11 minus 1 will give you 10 over here. Suppose if they are asking you to find out the 12th term, so A plus 11D. So these are the tricks that you should be very clear with. Same way, if they are asking you to find out the ratio of 29 term to 19 term, so it goes this way. T of 29 upon T of 19, which will be equal to A plus 28D. Now you should not be shocked looking at this 28. As we have seen here, this is the output. Upon next, it would be A plus 18D. Yes. Now you need to find out the ratio, and your answers has to be from A, B, C, D. Very simple, we have to make use of this given material, that is A plus 8D ka answer is 0. What we do here is, we break this, the ratio that we have got, into A plus 8D plus 20D we are left out, upon again A plus 8D plus 10D you are left out. Now sir, what on earth made you realize that we are supposed to put this into A plus 8D? Because we have got the answer for A plus 8D as 0. So what we do in our next step? In our next step, we do 0 plus 20D upon 0 plus 10D. Now, when you have this type of equation clear, so D and D, the 0 gets cancelled. Again, this 0. So 2 upon 1 is your answer. I click on this and I move ahead. I explain this sum once again. This is the general formula with respect to ninth term. The value of ninth term is given as 0. A plus 9 minus 1 into D. You should be aware, ninth term ka answer has to be A plus 8D, that the way we got. Now, we are supposed to make use of this A plus 8D in this question that we need. So intentionally what I did, A plus 28D and A plus 18D ko I have splitted as A plus 8D, A plus 8D, so that I can feed 0 over here like this, and remaining what I'm left out with is 20D upon 10D. Quickly, my answer is equal to 2 upon 1 and I click here. We go to the next one. Which term? Now, when you come across such type of questions, which term? You have to say to yourself, which term, matlab, I need to find out n. Okay? Yes, one more thing you need to cross check. Is the question giving you that the given sequence is in AP or not? If not, we have to work out whether the given sequence is in AP. It is specified that the given sequence is in AP. So yes, I put up my simple formula, T of n is equals to A plus n minus 1 into D. In this, T of n, they are saying which term of AP so and so is 0. So I'll try to figure out each and everything from the formula itself. 92 is nothing but A. T of n is nothing but the last term. They are saying, they are specifying, they are giving you the destination of the term ka value, which is 0. So this 0 is playing a role of T of n. So I got T of n as well. Now, difference. Because the sequence is in AP, difference of the preceding minus the succeeding means 88 minus 92 mein D ka answer is minus 4. What you need to do is, dear students, simple apply the values in the given formula. Instead of T of n, you'll put 0. Instead of A, you will write 92 plus. Instead of n, you will put n minus 1 and difference is minus 4. Be careful in terms of your calculation. Drag 92 over here, minus 92 is equals to n minus 1 into minus 4. Let your individual flow be maintained. Do not look at the answer until and unless you have got your own. So when we talk about n, don't open this. So when you want to find out the value of n minus 1, drag minus 4 on the left side. So minus 92 by minus 4 gives you minus minus gets cancelled. 4 1s are, 4 2s are and 4 3s are. Is 23 there in the answer? Yes. My hard work is successful. So this is how you should move ahead. Let's take a look at the next one. The nth term of even natural number. Now when we talk about nth term of even natural number, there is a formula which I would like to share with you all. It's here. Sum of natural numbers. Okay. This is S of n ka formula definitely. Sum of natural numbers, sum of even natural numbers and sum of odd natural numbers. It is given by a particular format which will make your work easier. Likewise, when we go for this particular question, the nth term of even natural number is nth term of even natural number. You come across such type of question means they are asking you T of n in general. Remember, whenever nth term means T of n is asked, you are not supposed to substitute the value of n. Rest everything would be substituted. Let us judge the sequence here first. The nth term of even natural number. So what will I say to my mind? As a part of my solution, I will say the even natural numbers that come to my mind are 2, 4, 6, 8 and ... Okay. Now when we talk about these even natural numbers, what will we do? The term is in AP where A is equals to 2, D is equals to 2 because 4 minus 2 ka answer is 2, 6 minus 4 ka answer is also 2. And you need not substitute the value of n. Aapko T of n ka answer n ke terms mein lana hai. So T of n is equals to A plus n minus 1 into D. Okay. This is just rough scribbling and then you can get your answer from the desired options and we move ahead. T of n mein, T of n ka value we need to find out because this is a question mark. I again repeat, whenever you want to find out T of n, do not substitute the value of n. A ke badle mein hum 2 likhenge plus n remains as it is, minus 1, and difference is 2 over here. That gives you 2 plus 2n minus 2. Your final answer is 2n. This is my answer that I have worked out. Let me see whether it is a part of option or not. And it is there. And hence we move to the next one. For any given AP, if T30 is equal to 2 times of T15, 15 term, then we need to search out the option. Here the trick would come into the picture. When I am saying T30, means can you say as per our trick, it would be what in terms of A and D, students? It would be yes, A plus 29D. When we are talking about T30, when I drag this information over here and I put up 30th term is equals to 2 times of 15th term. So instead of 30th term, quickly I can write A plus 29D, which will be equal to 2 times of A plus 14D. Correct? You need to solve this equation. Believe me, one option has to be there from A, B, C, and D. Let's quickly solve this. So A plus 29D, which is equals to 2A plus 28D. All the options are having A as positive. Be smart enough. Then you throw tantrums. Arey, mera answer to A ka negative mein aa raha hai. And then you need to drift. Be smart enough right from the beginning. Keep your A positive. That means I'll drag this over here. So it becomes 2A minus A plus 28D minus 29D. What we are left out here with is 0. As you can see, all the options are having 0. Means I'm moving on the right track. So 2A minus A is A. And plus 28 minus 29 is minus D. So my answer for A minus D is 0. This A is the answer. Enjoying the show? This is how your exam would move. So remove that fear factor from your mind. Let's take a next. Now, sum of the sequence. 50% of the crowd at the first go finds this difficult. What is this sum of N? One thing to be remembered here is when you are talking about sum of the terms, again, those sum of the terms in your syllabus would be in AP as it is given to find the sum of the n terms of the sequence, which is in AP. When the sequence is in AP, there are two formulas that are put up, formula number 1 and formula number 2. Sabse pehle S of n ka meaning kya hota hai? Let us understand. Suppose if I'm giving you a sequence which is say 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. I put up this as a, okay, I'll give you the options here so that both the formulas are clear. So I put dot, 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 dot here. And 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, I put a full stop over here. There is a big difference between this. This sequence that I have put up is called as infinite sequence in AP. Infinite sequence in AP. Now, when I'm talking about this sequence, this is called as finite sequence. Now, why finite? Because there is no term over here. Iske aage kuch bhi nahi hai. There is a full stop. Now, here if you observe, there is a dot, dot, there are dots. Means this is in continuation. This is called as infinite sequence. Now, this is not a rule, but I'll tell you, you go for finite sequence ke liye, this formula, and this is for infinite sequence. Now, what do you mean by S of n? Let us understand the meaning of the word S of n first. Okay. S of n. If I consider a sequence that was previously written over here, say 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, a finite one, and at a click, I ask you the total of all these three numbers. So, sabse pehle to hum logo ko pata hona chahiye ki how many numbers are there. There are five numbers, there are five terms, and if I want to find out the total of these terms, so you will say 3 plus 6 is 9, 9 plus 9 is 18, 18 plus 12 is 30, and plus 15 is 45. No, this is not the way. This is not 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. No. So, hence this formula comes into picture. And how do you connect it with arithmetic progression ka formulas? This role of the first term is A. 6 minus 3 is your difference. Okay? Now, when I am talking about every constituent, n, कितना terms है, how many terms are there? It should be there in the question, or you need to work it out as per the requirement. If this value of n is not given in the question, you need to work out, or else the value given is to be feeded over here. Rest A and D, we are both well versed with. So suppose if there are 5 terms over here, I am connecting it with this formula. I need to find out S of 5. So the role of n is played by 5 over here. This n is nothing but 5. So you should, as I said in the previous one, you should be literally doing a kind of postmortem to the formula. Agar aapko formula ke constituents pata hai, you will be getting each and every answer very easily. So second formula of S of n, we'll work it out. In fact, try to understand. Again, n is a term for which we are talking the value of. T1 is nothing but your value of first term, and Tn is nothing but the value of last term. Which formula to use and when will give you more confidence when we take the sums based on this. Let's move ahead. Well, one more thing that I had taken points to remember. There are certain fixed type of question. Find the sum of natural numbers. Find the sum of even natural numbers. Find the sum of odd natural numbers. So when we talk about natural numbers, the answer is n into n plus 1 upon 2. Ek chota sa discussion lete hain. How do you get this? When we talk about natural numbers, so you need to find out S of n. S of n ka formula is n upon 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into t. I'm just trying to explain as to how do you get this formula over here. So we keep n upon 2 as it is. Now, when we talk about natural numbers 1, 2, 3 and so on, the role of A is played by 1. So I write 1 instead of A plus S of n we need to work out, so we won't substitute the value of n over here. N remains n minus 1 into difference 2 minus 1, 3 minus 1. The common difference is 1. So instead of D, I will put up the value as 1. So 1 into the n minus 1 bracket gives you the same stuff. Now what we are left out next is n upon 2 into inside the bracket 2 plus n minus 1, which is equals to n upon 2 into n plus 1. Now if you observe, this n upon 2 into n plus 1 is the same thing. So instead of doing this hard work, this entire thing, why don't we try to memorize few things? Yes, it will make your work easier in the MCQs format. So sum of natural numbers, sum of even natural numbers and sum of odd natural numbers will make your sums very simple, dear students. And I will make you realize what type of questions are there that will give you good confidence. Let's take the sums ahead. Again, there is another type of sequence in AP that we need to assume. We'll have a look at this later on. Let's move to the next part. If the nth term of AP is 2n plus 1, then the sum of its first three terms is, as I said, if and then means if के बाद में हमें जो भी दिया है इट इज गिवन nth टर्म ऑफ एपी. नाउ व्हेन दे आर सेइंग nth टर्म मींस दिस इज नथिंग बट टी ऑफ एन. सो व्हाट विल आई डू एज अ पार्ट ऑफ माय सॉल्यूशन, आई जस्ट गो विद टी ऑफ एन फर्स्ट. टी ऑफ एन इज गिवन बाय 2n प्लस 1. दिस इज व्हाट द क्वेश्चन सेज. दे एक्सपेक्ट अस टू फाइंड आउट द सम ऑफ फर्स्ट थ्री टर्म्स. फर्स्ट थ्री टर्म्स का सम मतलब आई नीड s ऑफ 3. ओके, सो व्हेन आई पुट s ऑफ 3, आई गो विद difference wala formula. I should have the sequence first. So S of 3, I'll just put up the formula here. It would be 3 upon 2 into 2a plus n ke badle mein again 3 minus 1 into d. The things that weren't clear to my mind, I have put up here. I don't know the value of a, I don't know the value of d. I will work out here. I'll put up t of n instead of n, I'll put 1. So I'll get 2 plus 1 which is equals to 3. I'll put T2 which is equals to 2 into 2 plus 1 which is 4 plus 1 which is 5. Then T3 will give me 7 as my answer, which goes somewhat this way, 6 plus 1 which is 7. So if you understand, we have just sorted our sequence. Our sequence is 3, 5, 7. Now everything can be feeded here. The role of A is played by 3. And the role of D is played by 2. 5 minus 3 is 2. I'll just put up here into the formula. So it's like 3 upon 2 into the bracket 2 into, instead of A, you will put up 3 over here plus 2D. Instead of D also, you are going to put 2. And everything is ready with us. We are waiting for our answer, which is 6 plus 4, which is 3 upon 2 into 10. That's 2 ones are and 5s are. 5 threes are 15. As I solve my MCQs in the format, I get my own answer. My answer over here is 3 5s are 15. So when I say 15, it is there available in the option to me. This is how we move ahead with the sum. We go to the next one. 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus dot 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 till 100. Now here comes the formula that I would show here. The numbers that you all can see here, 1, 2, 3, 4 till 100. These are natural numbers. Natural numbers ke liye formula sum chahiye. The sum of numbers from 1 to 100. Orally to kisi ko bhi nahi aayega. But yes, I had said to remember the formula for S of N for natural numbers is given by N into N plus 1 into upon 2. Let's take a quick recap over here. Here is the formula, students. This is sum of natural numbers. We go back to the sum and just substitute it. Sir, how many terms? 1 se lekar 100 tak hai, toh number of terms is 100. I put 100 over here and 100 plus 1, the whole upon 2, that gives me 50 outside. So it's like 50 into 101, which gives you 5050 as your answer. It's there in the option. We move to the next. So you saw the formulas which we had derived for natural numbers, for even natural numbers, and for odd natural numbers are so helpful to find out S of N. Let's take the next one. The sum of 20 even natural numbers. Yes, here comes the second formula. When we are talking about even natural numbers, if someone has taken a snapshot of the formulas that I had given, it's very clear in my mind. It's N into N plus 1. The formula for even natural numbers. Ek bar fir se us screen ki or chalte hain and let's have a look at these formulas. Even natural number is given by N into N plus 1. So here we go with the sum, and the sum on the board S of N for even natural number is given by this formula. The role of N is played by 20. So S of 20 is equals to 20 into 20 plus 1, which is equals to 20 into 21. The answer is 420. Mind you, this is my answer. I am searching for the answer. It's there. I give a tick and I move to my next MCQ. The next MCQ is all done. I hope you all enjoyed the show, my dear students. See, one small thing I would like to request you all. Do not panic. It's an MCQ based exam. You have too much of time to think over a question, but you need to be conceptually clear. So Arihant Academy has taken a good initiative to come closer to your queries and solve them. I hope everyone enjoyed the session and you all liked the show. And if you really liked it, please like, share and subscribe the YouTube channel of Arihant Academy. God bless you all. Stay tuned. See you all. Bye-bye.